Hello everyone, I'm Sam and welcome back to Deus Ex, Mankind Divided. Last time I forgot to start this side quest, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that. We are looking for any evidence that might point us to where Vincent Black is located, at the request of Delara Alzan. Let's go ahead and just loot his office though, from top to bottom.
Anomaly detected.
Uh-oh.
Trace program initiated.
Might have to nuke a couple of these.
Access granted.
That might have been overkill, but level 5 terminals are usually worth it. Well, not in this case. A train ticket. Heading to Berlin. Huh? Okay. Maybe there's some more info on that in his email. And we can even use this password that we so conveniently got several episodes ago. Origami 1970. Enter. Yep, what do we got here? He's talking to someone named D. Novakova. A one-way ticket to Berlin. Red Queen in an hour.
Delara, I'm in Vince's office. I think I have a lead. An appointment Vince made with an informant.
That sounds promising, Adam. You willing to follow up?
Only way to find out what happened to him.
If something happened to him. Let's not assume the worst just yet.
It's usually, in stories like this, pretty safe to assume the worst. I apologize in advance if there were any audio issues in the last few episodes. I turned down my sample rate to try to, you know, eliminate some audio latency, and I noticed that it was adding some kind of, you know, popping noises and other minor distortion into the audio track. So if, you know, you noticed that, then I apologize. If you didn't notice it and you are only noticing it now, then I double apologize. But hopefully, it'll be taken care of. So, our current goals. Let's see. We have a point of interest in the other side of town to find the glitchy AI, the AI that said that it found us, so we need to find it. We need to confront Stanek, and we need to do some side quests. We need to infiltrate the Diwali safe house and take down Dominic for Masa Cadlic. And now we need to head back to the Red Queen in order to confront Vincent Black's informant to see if we can find out where he is. I'm beginning to think that TF-29 just doesn't have any other officers, and they just make Adam do everything. I would also like to pay a visit to a vendor before I head over there. One that will actually buy my items. I think it might be worth the detour back to 33 Hlavni, just to sell our items.
Just make it through this shift.
Asking yes to help.
Do you want our money or not?
That's equipped.
Man, I absolutely adore this part of the game. Hey, wake up, buddy. It feels really open-ended, but everything feeds back into each other. You'll get, you know, hints and tips on side quests when you're doing other quests, and it feels, you know, really natural.
You gotta
Gonna go ahead and skip his dialogue since we've heard it before. What does he have? Anything new? Well, now he sells a sniper rifle and the Devastator shotgun. And the Lancer rifle. You know, I don't remember these weapons. But we're not really gonna buy them, so it's unfortunate. Can sell that sniper rifle and the 10mm, as well as this trank ammo. And we can sell the battle rifle ammo, sniper ammo. Everything else we use frequently enough that I'll keep it around. I kind of don't need the regular revolver ammo since our current revolver only uses armor piercing.
I'm trying.
And no. We're done with you.
He's going to be trouble.
Cutting edge security measures.
Jump down. And now we can make our way back to the red light district.
Hey.
Can't defend against that kind of thing.
What I would really like to be able to do is kind of cluster my Diwali side quests all at once so that we only have to make one or two trips into the Diwali headquarters. But if that's not possible, and we have to go back multiple times, that's fine.
Enough problems already.
If we do a good enough job clearing it out the first time, then it shouldn't be a problem the second time, right? We should probably pay lip service to the main story and talk to Stanek first.
Welcome to my place. Didn't expect to see one of you in here. Not today. You know, with all the trouble.
We're not gonna have a problem, are we?
No, no. I don't share the sentiment of the ruling class. Just commenting on current events, you know? About the happening in Utalek. So, what can I get you?
You can get me nothing, because nothing. I thought you would tell me where Stanek was.
Galwa guy gave me the creeps.
I went to the wrong bar. Whoops. Maybe you know.
Welcome to the Irish stool, buddy. Pull one up and I will see what we can do for you.
Irish stool. Catchy name. Very evocative.
I like to think so. Well, what will it be?
Looking for a man named Nomad Stanek. Heard he might be in here.
Yeah, you're not the first. Couple of Interpol agents asked me about him too. What did he do? Is he in trouble or something?
I can't go into details about an ongoing investigation. Where did you say they were?
Downstairs. Don't mess up the place, okay? By the way, you want anything?
We don't need to buy anything. Although, man, look at that lapel tie thing he's got going on. Of all the weird fashion in this game, this one might be the weirdest yet. Either that or Smiley's plastic sleeves.
Hey, I'm a citizen! I have rights! You cannot detain me without charging me! This I know!
And I know you're gonna sit there quietly and wait with us like a good little watchmaker.
I've got this, Agent Riley. You and your partner can relax for a few minutes.
Wait a minute. I know you. You've been in my shop. What is this?
You have some things to answer for, Mr. Stanek. We have evidence linking you and your shop to the train station bombing.
Bombing? No! I would never... I wouldn't even know where to start. You have the wrong man.
Do I? Convince me. I have a timing device with your name on it, and I found the tools to make even more bombs in your apartment. What else am I supposed to think?
But you've been to my shop. You know I fix watches. I don't make bombs. No, those tools aren't mine. They belong to my...
Your daughter?
No, no. Look, take me in. I'm the one you're looking for, not her. I have made bombs for them.
I don't think so. Protecting your daughter is admirable, Mr. Stanek. But you're not doing her any good by taking the blame. You need to tell me what you know.
You're right, I know. Allison was in the military. She always wanted to belong, to be part of something greater than herself. She was such a beautiful child, gifted.
What happened?
After the incident, she met some people. They said they were her friends, but I could see they only wanted to use her. Parasites, and now they have taken her. You must help. She is not to blame for this. She has been coerced.
Calm down. What do you mean they've taken her?
Allison and I were supposed to meet here tonight. Instead, one of them came by, spewing curses about fleshers and naturals. He gave me a message from her. She was saying goodbye. But she would never. They used her, and now they intend to make her disappear.
Man. So, yeah, looks like Stanek isn't actually the one making bombs. It's his daughter, Allison. Let's keep digging and learn more about her.
Does your daughter have the expertise to do this?
Much more than I do. She was in the military. EOD, they called it. Explosive Ordnance Disposal.
The bombs what?
Yes. She was happy in the military. They augmented her, rebuilt her to make her better at what she did. But after the incident, she was dishonorably discharged. She was lost.
That's when these new friends found her.
Duh! They exploited her, and now they plan to discard her.
Okay, well, what about the lab in your apartment?
Your apartment was booby-trapped by Radich Nikoladze.
What? Why would he... I guess friendship means nothing to a thug.
What happened?
I was never a wealthy man, but my shop is well known and respected. Radich liked my watches. He knew I needed money after what happened to Allison, so we strike a deal. Deals are like beautiful women to that man. A better one always comes around.
What do you know about these friends of hers?
Other than they were augmented? Not much. They only spoke to Allison when they came to the shop. As if anyone unaugmented was beneath them. They kept talking about the Ascension, whatever that is.
Oh, great. So it looks like Allison might have fallen in with that cult
Where
that we
I
met
Allison, Mr. Stanek?
Way back in, what, episode
I
2?
I would go and get her away from those people. I was about to go looking for her when your goon showed up.
We'll find her. I need you to go with these agents. I'll have some more questions for you.
No! I have to go! I have to help her! She's all I have.
Please, let us do our job.
Find my daughter, or I will!
Smiley, I spoke to Stanek. He's not our guy, but he has a daughter. Allison, ex-military EOD. She might be the bomb maker.
So what's our next move?
Stanek says he doesn't know where she is, but I think he's hiding something. The agents are bringing him in. Until he gives her up, this investigation is stalled.
I'll make sure they lean on him, see what he knows.
Good. Let me know what happens.
Adam, Janus heard the NSN conversation we recovered. He agrees you two should meet.
Good. Just tell me where.
There's an abandoned tourist information center in the central plaza. Make sure you're not followed. And I got something on Marchenko for you, too. Details are on a pocket secretary near the meetup point. Look for a trash bin with a chalk mark above it. You'll find it near the metro.
Feel that rhythm. Looking for... Vince Black's contact. Probably out here on the bar. Or the
My
patio.
Favorite color is about this place or what?
What about you?
Absolutely.
D. Novakova, huh?
Are you Vincent Black? It's me, Dobromila. Please, you... No, you are too... I'm sorry. I have made a mistake. I'm waiting for someone.
Yeah. That person is me, Vincent Black.
You really think you should be saying my name out loud in a place like this?
So it is you. Discretion. Right. I'm sorry. But it was your bright idea to meet here, of all places. Not exactly the safest part of Prague to... You didn't mention that you were augmented in your description.
What difference does it make?
None, I suppose. And I don't mean to stare. It's just... It doesn't fit with your reputation.
My reputation, huh? Man's not always aware of what people say about him. What else have you heard?
People are wary of you. They say that you are everyone's enemy, everyone's friend. They also say you are one of the few who has the courage to expose the Diwali for what they really are. I can help with that. But first, I need to know I can trust you.
What kind of trouble are you in, exactly?
You know exactly what kind of trouble I'm in. My husband, Ballista, the operation, you've been digging into it. Come closer. Pretend you're kissing my neck.
Your husband runs a Diwali operation. I'm assuming there are people in here who know who he is. You don't think me kissing his wife might draw unwanted attention?
Flirting is one thing. They expect it. He cheats on me, I cheat on him. But his business is something else entirely. We must be discreet, darling. Please, I'll tell you whatever I can. Whatever you want. But not here. This isn't the time to ask questions. You understand, yes?
Yes.
We should talk somewhere else.
I am leaving by train tonight. There is a secluded courtyard by the tracks, Shikashka. Go before me and I'll meet you there. I don't want anyone to see us walking out together.
You sure you'll be all right until then?
I've survived marriage to that man for this long. I think I can make it one more night. I'll be okay. I just need another drink to get my courage up and to loosen my tongue. We'll see each other soon, I promise.
I think the way that they recorded her her voice doesn't really do her any favors. But yeah, it's kind of weird that Vincent apparently has a bunch of courage for being willing to expose the Diwali when the Diwali seem to be, you know, pretty open about their criminal activity. What with the whole heading to people's apartments and making bomb puns thing. Let's see, we should have enough time to head... Oh, what's over here? Janice, huh? Well, we should probably do our side quest first.
Get lost. This place is not for you. Turn around, Clank. Uyovki are not allowed inside.
Okay. Understood. So this large area of the map...
Delara, you there?
What is it, Adam? Any word on what happened to Vince?
I just spoke to his contact. A woman he was supposed to meet to get info on some Diwali op. Problem is, he never showed up.
I have a really bad feeling about this. Do whatever you can, Adam, to pick up his trail. Let's hope he's alright.
This physics object isn't working with me here. Wanted to make it up to this ladder. But we are heading into the actual Diwali compound. The main Diwali hangout in Prague. We'll be paying at least one more visit here later in the game.
I never saw a man try harder to look like he came up from the streets.
Dominique. He's got the ink. He's done time.
So, do we have a secondary objective here? I can't remember if we need... Okay.
Time.
We have to be careful not to kill Dominic.
Think he got that shit on his legs in prison? Radich made the call. You want to talk to Radich about who he recruits? Good luck.
If he wants posers, my hometown is full of them.
You know the deal. Some guys are for doing the shooting, and some are for getting shot.
Guess Dominic's being set up.
They just dropped!
Exactly what I said.
So, we can take down as many of these guys as we want, as long as we don't kill Dominic. Another pistol we can sell. And you should have one as well. But it'll just turn into some ammo. Nope, maybe not. This area is very hostile, and there are a lot of Diwali henchmen.
You interested in what I got?
Come on, Adam, what was that action roll? Turn this camera off. Now, Dominic is on the floor below. So we just need to make our way downstairs, and we are good to go. Oh, an air vent. Where does this lead? I guess into the apartment? Nope, into the garage. Okay. I guess that punching bag isn't unique. Can I take any of that? Nope. Anything in here? Hypostim. Beer. I might as well just drink that now before it just takes up a spot in our inventory forever. What's one for the road? Oh shit. Can't actually stealth here.
Have to get the girls to bring in the laundry. Looks like it will rain.
What's the best way to handle this? I kind of want to run to that cover and take down the camera. Should probably switch to the stun gun, just in case I accidentally hit Dominic. Alright, we're good. Let's disable this. As long as we're fast, this shouldn't be a problem. Tactical shotgun, that's another basically $1,000.
Dominic, can you talk?
Oh, you're Dominic, huh? Yep, he's got the tattoo. Put him in the locker. Oh, I suppose they mean the locker that we... Uh-oh. Guess they mean the locker that we were just in? Keep dropping his body. Let's just go ahead and disable this camera again. Which locker do they refer to? Come on, Dominic. Oh, please tell me you're not clipped into geometry. Okay, good. Does that do it? No, it does not. Do I need to storm in the other locker? Keep turning this camera off until I figure it out. Should be an easy enough hack. I say taking probably the most inefficient way through it possible. Maximizing our chances of detection.
Access granted.
Let's try this one. Damn.
I have been informed of a disturbance at the Hotel Naricola. I don't know you, and I don't know what you are doing there. Never approach me again, and watch your back.
Well, so much for that. Let's actually go ahead and load the autosave. It's a little scummy, but we were fortunate enough to get one right when we knocked out Dominic. And I hate failing a side quest just because, you know, I'm incompetent. When it means I might be missing out on, you know, showing off part of the game. Might actually be wise, while the camera is disabled, to just nip that problem in the bud. Drop Dominic. And hey, we even know the faster way through this hacking challenge now.
Access granted.
And got it. Did that do it? It did not? What am I missing here? Store Dominic in the locker. In the locker, huh? Which locker are you referring to, side quest? I would think it would be one of these. But I guess not. Well, let's just pick up Dominic again and drop him somewhere else this time. Maybe he would just be too easy to find in that storage container. Oh. Anything? Store Dominic in the locker. Oh, I have to actually take him out of the area? Oh, we don't want to go that way. That's for sure. Let's just take him upstairs. Whoop. Just disable this camera. And take it down. I think this is where we came in. Let's go ahead and take him out this way. That radio is playing the Hong Kong music from the original Deus Ex. Yep, this is where we need to go. Alright, so we do need to actually use this thing. Because, and I love this detail, if we were to just drop Dominic from the second floor of a building, he would die. Oh, don't you fall. Good enough. Oh, you better not be stuck. Come on, Dom. There we go. Maybe if we just toss him around a little bit. This quest is clever, but the physics of the game do not do it any favors. Mission complete. At long last. Go ahead and close the locker.
Cadillac, I delivered your boy Dominic. No one saw me go in or out.
Impressive. How is he?
He's still out cold. Might want to ease off on the bright lights when he comes around.
I'll keep that in mind. We do want him to be as attentive as possible. I think this concludes our business tonight.
All right. And that also concludes this episode. So, as always, I'm Sam. This has been Deus Ex Mankind Divided. And I hope to see you next time. Until then.